All right, let's get started, shall we? I am the Western Jesus, a.k.a. William Mark Thomas. You may know me from the Jay and Mark show on Mad Archer Media. And this is my solo, somewhat solo podcast, episode number one, actually, of the Western Jesus podcast. This episode isn't really going to be much of what other episodes may be like, but this one's going to go ahead and I'm going to let you guys hear the extended Batman v Superman review with my guest reviewer, Brett the Shitman Fart, a.k.a. Brett Sherrard.
Fuck all of you.
We talked for a good hour and 40-some minutes that night about Batman v Superman. Somewhat. that 41-minute review I put out last week, that was just all the parts that were truly about Batman v Superman, because we just can't help ourselves. We just love talking to each other about all kinds of shit. But so I figured I'd go ahead and let you guys hear it, just because it was pretty entertaining and it was a good conversation. I figured the viewers may enjoy it as well. But Brett will be back. If you guys enjoy Brett, he will be
Fuck
back.
All of you.
Quite often, I believe.
Fuck all of you.
But yeah, I guess I'll just get right to it and let you guys hear it. Here is the extended review for Batman v Superman featuring Brett Sherrard on the Western Jesus podcast. Episode number one. Here we go.
Fuck all of you.
Where does the mind go? There it is. Alright, so are we doing introductions here?
Yeah, because I'm going to do it through the Western Jesus podcast, because you're going to be like a regular guy on there, right?
Yes, sir.
Cool, I'm going to make you sign something. No, I'm just kidding.
This has been the most pot-filled litigation I've been through.
Really?
Yeah.
There you have it. First time for everything.
Brett sending away his life to Western Jesus. The real Jesus.
It sounds way more dramatic if Jesus is involved. Even if it is a Western version. But I guess with that said, here is the Batman vs. Superman review on the Western Jesus podcast featuring Brett Sherrard, a.k.a. Brett the Shitman Fart. How are you today, sir?
I'm not feeling particularly shitty, as my name suggests.
No, do you enjoy that name or not?
No, it's fun. I'm not going to go introduce myself as that, but if somebody said it, I'll just kind of nod and be like, yeah, that's cool. Sorry, I smacked the mic.
That's all good. That's all good. All right, good to know.
Yes.
Because I believe in the first episode I refer to you as Brett the Shitman Fart as well. So I also call
That's my radio name now, you know.
Well, yeah, that's what I figure. Yeah, I mean, maybe it'll change over time, but like as of right now, you are
the success of this show is gonna have me wearing, you know, pink tank tops and Jerry Curl with my black sunglasses on.
Damn,
looking. But it's all gonna be extra shitty looking. You know, people are gonna have T-shirts of me.
Yeah.
Brett the Shitman Fart. Kids are going to get kicked out of school for wearing those shirts.
You're absolutely right. And I'm going to be the person to produce them. Along with the Batgirl shirt.
So they can have us in their hearts and their homes.
Yep.
So, this Batman vs. Superman thing.
Yes.
That's a big thing everyone's happening about.
Yes, we've both seen it. I believe we've both seen it. Twice,
yes,
in one form or another.
Yeah, I watched it twice. I watched it in 3D yesterday. Got to say that extra $3 kind of wasn't worth it.
Really? I imagine it.
It looks exactly the same in 3D and 2D to me.
Really?
Like, yeah,
it probably wasn't shot in 3D. Only movies that are shot and intended, like created to be in 3D are the only ones that are interesting in 3D.
Yeah.
I really am not.
Yeah, like Star Wars in 3D was really cool.
See, I've never seen a 3D movie. That's
what you haven't?
Yeah, I'm not really one to talk about it, really, but...
I like the real D, like, now that it's not those red and blue glasses.
Yeah.
Those things were just obnoxious.
Yeah, well, I've saw 3D movies back in, like, the early days of 3D movies. Like, my dad took me to... Back when it was just, like, weird documentary films about, like, people in the 40s coming to America and shit.
I don't know why you'd want to see that in 3D.
I know. Because it was, like... It had something to do with a theme park as well. Like, it was, like, Pacific Ocean Park in California, the POP in Venice, California, where there's, like, roller coasters and shit on the pier. So, the 3D of it was you were riding on the roller coaster, and it was like you were really on a roller coaster. Really, it just made people fucking sick because it was the early days of 3D, and it wasn't really that great. But I'm getting off the subject.
Oh, shit.
I've never seen a 3D movie, so I really can't talk about it. But I notice in 3D movies when... when you're watching them in 2D and standard, that you can tell when this moment was intended for 3D.
Yeah.
Like, when I saw Oz the Great and Powerful, there's a part where, I don't even know why, but there's just a shit ton of butterflies flying at the screen. I was like, that is only cool if you see it in 3D. You know what I mean? There's a few moments in that movie, but I believe that movie was shot and intended to be in 3D.
Yeah. Yeah, that's what was advertised in 3D, The Wizard of Oz. With that guy, James Franco, that's in love with Seth Rogen.
Yeah. I think it's also... I think
this
it's
is how I'm going to get famous, by dropping names in the first episode.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't know James Franco and Seth Rogen, but I'm sure we'd get along very well, fellas.
Oh, yes. Yes, especially if weed's involved, probably. But yes, the Batman vs. Superman movie.
It was... What was your favorite part?
First off, I guess I should say this is going to have spoilers.
Yeah, oh yeah. This is for people who've watched the fucking movie.
Yeah, yeah. If you haven't seen it by now...
Don't watch reviews on shit you haven't fucking watched, asshole.
Yeah, so as of right now, I'm going to let you know that from here on out, there will be spoilers. So... If you don't want it spoiled, don't fucking watch this. And shame on you if you do want it spoiled, because that's bullshit.
Yeah. Oh, dude, last night when I watched it, when Superman died, this dude was in the way back, and he's just like, oh, what the hell? I was dying.
I believe it. I believe it.
Like, we're walking out of the theater, and he's just walking up behind us. He's like, how are you going to kill Superman? He's like, how are you going to kill Superman? And I'm like, Jesus fuck, dude.
No, I mean, I understand. That's one of the things I kind of had a problem with, is they crammed so damn much into 2.5 hours. But I feel like that should have been its own movie, kind of. Like, that should have been Man of Steel 2 or something.
Yeah.
Well, or maybe it happened, it's the plot of Justice League or something.
It is. I mean, that's what it is. It's a prequel to Justice League.
Yeah, yeah.
Except they're not doing the prequel 12 years after the first movie. They're doing it before the movie.
Yeah, yeah. It's weird, but...
It's interesting because at first my brother was talking about the... he's like, yeah, I like the Crisis on Two Earths, you know, nod. And I'm like, what the fuck are you talking about? And he started talking about... how he thought it was going to lead into a Crisis on Two Earths thing because of the Flash coming back. But I remembered what Crisis on Two Earths was like, and like it has to be Flashpoint Paradox.
That's
that really makes sense.
That's where I think it's going to, because they set up they got like a really good actor to play Thomas Wayne.
Yeah,
Jeffrey Dean Morgan is the shit, and he would be a fucking perfect
Thomas Wayne
Batman, dude. He'd be great. And Flashpoint Paradox is a great, probably my favorite animated movie they put out.
Yeah.
So that would be awesome if they did that. But that, to answer your question, is my favorite part, the appearance of Flash through time.
Yeah. Hell yeah. Well,
so awesome.
I was there. I liked the Batman and Batman beating the shit out of those dudes in the warehouse. That was just, it reminded me too much of the Arkham games.
No, that was awesome. I loved that part of the movie as well.
Honestly, even the second time, the part where he's like, "Oh, don't let them kill Martha," and that's how they became friends.
Yeah, that
it was less corny the second time because, like, I even thought about it. I was like, "Well, he has been thinking about his parents a lot," so like, and then in the beginning of the movie when they show his parents getting killed, his dad's looking over and saying Martha.
Yeah,
and like, he sounds almost exactly the same.
Yeah, yeah, no, they definitely
sounds all desperate and scared.
That's a big reason why I watched the movie again as well. And that's why the movie, watching it the second time, made me like it even more.
It doesn't seem like it's as long. It takes as long to watch it the second time.
No, I feel that way with like every movie though. Like when I see a movie in theaters, I always feel I'm always kind of like.
Yeah, I there's I don't parts in the trailer there. I wanted to see.
Yeah, well, not that. It's more like. Like I'd rather watch it at home because I think most of the time when I see it a second time, it's when I'm watching it at home. And I could smoke, you know what I mean? I could eat something. I could go take a piss if I want to and not miss anything. Like, I don't really like the experience of being in the theater with people, you know what I mean?
Yeah. I'm really looking forward to the Justice League now, though. Like, I was up in the air, and then after seeing this movie, I really want to see The Flash. That's going to be awesome. Wonder Woman's going to be cool.
Seeing the little bit of Flash that they showed you in the movie, even the like surveillance footage and shit, like that, those were some of the most exciting parts of the movie for me. Like things I got most psyched about. Seeing Jason Momoa come out as Aquaman and fucking do that pulse through the water and shit, that was awesome.
You know, I just now thought about how people complain about, you know, there's not a lot of story development and character development. Like, yeah. You get that in the Avengers movies, dude. There's like 15 characters in there. They don't get to stop to give every character an equal amount of time.
Especially recently, like the argument of them each getting their own standalone movie. Like now they're not even doing that. Like they've stopped doing that. Like they're doing
like Thor. I said, Captain America, Civil War is Avengers 3.
That's what it is, yeah. And isn't it a two-parter? Or did they, are they?
No, the Infinity Wars is two-parter.
Oh, you're that's right, yes. Yeah. So, yeah, that's pretty much got everyone in it except for, what, Thor and Hulk? Everyone in it except for Thor. And they're even throwing in all the new people.
Mm-hmm. Ant-Man, I was surprised Ant-Man was in there, and they're introducing characters like Black Panther and the new Spider-Man.
Mm-hmm. And really, they set it up in the end of Age of Ultron for them to not even be the Avengers anymore.
Yeah.
It's the new Avengers. They added Falcon and What's-Your-Nuts, Scarlet Witch.
Well, after the Avengers Infinity Wars, I thought they're like doing another phase into the Avengers where a lot of the original ones won't be in it.
Oh, see, I wasn't aware of that. I'm like I said, I'm a
like DC eventually, guy. You know, they're gonna get replaced with newer ones, and
oh yeah, of course,
you know, Iron like, Man and them works. Aren't Iron Man and them aren't really gonna be a part of it. It's gonna be more about Ant-Man and whoever.
That's sweet though, because I dug Ant-Man.
Still haven't got a chance to see it.
Yeah, man, it's cool. I like Paul Rudd. Paul Rudd's my dude.
Yeah. I'm interested in seeing him in that kind of role as a superhero.
He's good. He did it well, in my opinion.
I mean, I like the Coca-Cola commercial he did with the Incredible Hulk. That was awesome.
Yeah, that was cool. You didn't see
fantastic that, acting in that. I don't know how they got that pop can to look so small in the Hulk's hands. How'd that happen? Must be CGI. They made the Coke can a little smaller.
No, it was movie magic.
Forced perspective. Which is a real thing.
Yeah. That's how they do. CGI, that's like so 90s.
Yeah.
Oh, that's, early 2000s.
Yeah. You're so 2000 and late.
Well, I guess maybe we should have a more linear approach to this.
We're bouncing around. All right, let's take it from the very first second.
Well, I know a really good point to start with, and that is we see the origin of Batman again, but we've already discussed how it was necessary for the climax of the fight.
Yeah.
Now,
it was very relevant.
There was a lot of weird dreamy sequences in here. First, in the very first scene, him being lifted through the well up by bats, like being.
Yeah, that was weird.
That was very weird. And watching it, I'm like, what the hell is this?
Yeah, at first I was like, what the fuck? Until he woke up. Yeah.
And then I was like, okay, that's a dream. Okay, that's just something they felt like needed to happen. But whatever.
When the man bat comes out of the grave later, that was cool, a crazy dream too.
I liked seeing that though.
See, I really hope when they do the Batman movies, it's going to be really dark and almost like a horror movie, like that little scene where they introduced him.
That would be cool. Like,
you could make a Batman horror movie where it's not even about Batman fucking everybody up. It's just about everybody being scared of the Batman. You can make a
rated R Batman movie very easily and it'd be
successful. The Dark Knight Returns, man.
Right there. That's a perfect example. But you could make...
Or Death in the Family.
They need to make that shit. They kind of did it with Dark Knight a little bit, but they changed a lot of shit, and it was very brief. It was like just the last act, really. But that would be cool. I love that they're doing the animated Killing Joke,
though. Oh, yeah, that's going
to
be sweet.
That'd be something cool to see on the big screen.
But back to this Batman versus Superman.
Yeah, we keep getting off subject.
Stop these tangents, man. We have to have a little button to ding it.
Yeah, we should. That's usually... Emily should be here. Yeah.
Get the fuck in. Come on.
Yeah. Let us know. But very... A lot of dream sequences in here that I felt didn't need to happen most of the time. But...
Well, I thought about it, about the part where the Flash comes in.
The whole Dark Side Flash thing was definitely necessary for some reason. They didn't tell
you
why.
The reason it seemed like it was a dream, because like when you notice he woke up the second time, the papers were still flying around. So what it was is the time split just caused that little... It was just a bit of a time dilation to where, you know, he woke up and saw that, and then he woke up again. And it just seemed like a dream. But all the papers were still flying because, like, there's a whole bunch of bedlam going on.
Yeah, I guess I didn't catch on to that. Because that was very confusing to me, that whole thing. Like, I loved it. Like I said, that's probably my favorite part in the movie, is Flash just popping up. That whole part, the whole setup for Darkseid, just fucking awesome.
Just, like, I didn't pay attention to when he was just like, oh, shit, am I too early? Am I too early?
Yeah, he said...
I didn't catch that the first time.
He's telling him he's fucking... he was right about him all along, which I'm pretty sure he's talking about Darkseid. Most people probably thought he was talking about Superman.
Yeah, that's what it seemed like. You know, like, even at the end when he visits Luther in the jail cell, you know he's not talking about Superman, but at first I didn't even think about Darkseid. Like, I was like, maybe, and then... The parademons, I'm like, oh, yeah.
Yeah, seeing parademons was awesome, too.
I've started thinking about Superman in different ways now, though, too, because before I always kind of made the gripe that, you know, you take away his powers, he's not, like, anything. But you got to think about the psychological development of someone who's... He looks human. He passes for human very easily.
Yeah.
But, like, he's not. He knows he's not. He's super alienated in that way. And...
Yeah,
because he doesn't... Bruce Wayne was right. Like, he doesn't... He's not brave because he's not really a man. Like, he just does that stuff. It's nothing to him.
That's true. It's not something that, like, he can
control. But it made me appreciate his character a little more, you know, thinking about it in that way.
I've always liked Superman. People hate on him, but I like Superman.
I remember, like, watching the earlier cartoons where, like, he didn't even fly. He was just, you know, jumped. He could just jump really high.
Yep.
I don't think he was an alien. I don't know if there was that spin to it. I'm not even sure when that came along. Probably, like, in the 40s or 50s.
I don't know. I'm ignorant of comic book knowledge. Yeah.
Audience, please don't hate me.
Yeah. We're no experts.
I just watch movies, and I kind of know some stuff.
I read some comics, but I haven't read anything that old. You know what I mean?
Yeah. I mean, I remember watching the cartoons because when I lived with my grandparents, that's what my uncle would watch. I mean, grandpa would watch really old TV shows.
Well, I grew up watching, like, the Christopher Reeve. That's probably my first introduction to Superman was Christopher Reeve as fucking...
Yeah, you like how they did the little nod to Christopher Reeve as Superman when he's talking about when Bruce Wayne was just like, yeah, since you guys write a little puff piece about every time that your alien saves a cat out of a tree or something, which is like a nod to one of the first movies.
He totally did that in the movie, yeah.
Dude, I think Perry White knows Clark Kent is Superman. As that movie goes along, like, you know, he knows Clark Kent is Superman. Because he comes out and he's always looking for Clark when it's, you know, there's a bunch of shit going on with Superman. He comes out and he looks for Clark immediately. And then, you know, later on when Superman leaves because everyone hates him, you know, they thought he killed all those people. And he knows about Superman and, you know, Lois Lane. And then, you know, he's like, so Clark's not back yet or something like that? And
yeah.
Like he knows.
He's just like, oh, Clark's not back. Like, yeah, yeah. No, that makes perfect sense.
I think he knows, but he doesn't want to tell anybody because he still likes him, you know?
Well, maybe he's just like, I get it. You know what I mean? He's Superman. He's got to have some sort of life outside of that shit.
But. Yeah, he probably, like, I mean, he's probably like, you know, down under, like, I actually support Superman and whatever.
Yeah.
Even though he's in, you know.
Well, I mean, it would just make sense in the long run, like. It in this more realistic way that they're trying to portray it, how could you not fucking know that he's Superman?
The dude didn't become the editor of that fucking newspaper by not being some type of a decent journalist.
For sure. It's not like
you could tell, like, you just look at someone and you're like, yeah, that motherfucker is Superman. Like, I don't care if his hair's not slicked back.
That's like me putting on glasses and expecting you not to know it's me. You know what I mean?
To be fair, I was a little confused who you were just because you were wearing the hat earlier.
Oh, okay. Oh,
yeah, like you maybe covered, I'm I mean, just a weirdo. Yeah, I'm like, no, I'm just kidding.
I mean, I can imagine, like, maybe if I shaved my beard off, you know, be like, oh, shit, dude, you shaved your beard. Like, but even you would know it was me. You know?
Yeah, it just takes a little bit. You're just like, holy shit. Like, but everyone was when I shaved mine. We'll cut that part out.
No, we're leaving that in. I might turn it up a little bit. No, I'm just kidding.
But yeah, dude, like, that motherfucker has to know. And Lois Lane just pissed me off that whole fucking movie. When she sees that dude buffing the floors, and she recognizes him, she just goes, excuse me, do I know you? I'm like, you dumb bitch.
Like, how could you forget that motherfucker's face in the first... How could you not know who that was?
I mean, especially I don't know why... I think she did know him. She recognized him. I just don't know why she approached him.
Yeah, yeah.
That didn't make sense to me. Like, if I saw that dude who I knew killed a bunch of other people in the desert...
Exactly.
And I was almost killed there. I don't think I'd approach that dude.
She witnessed, like, one of the guys he was with murder her photographer.
Yeah.
Murder him, who was it was a cover up. He was a CIA agent or whatever. Yeah. Or FBI agent, I can't remember.
CIA.
Yeah. And just fucking murder him, straight up shoot him in the head. I would not forget any of those motherfuckers' faces, ever. As soon as I saw that guy, I'm like, that's that motherfucker. And I'd, like, go get Clark.
Yeah, but, like, something's going on here. Why is this dude I just watched kill a bunch of people not too long ago?
Waxing the
floors. Yeah, and he's, like, standing in one spot. He wasn't even moving around. He's just kind of standing there looking over his shoulder like a creep. Just
almost just like, man, I hope... How am I going to get Lois?
Yeah.
Oh, she's going to walk right into my hands. Yeah, awesome.
I think she's just going to walk right up to me when she sees me.
So I should just wax
the floor. Yeah, I'll just stand right here and do this. This is going to... Like, I think he was buffing, like, beneath the floor. I think he was down into the dirt.
He was... Yeah, he is.
He was buffing the...
He'd been there all day. Waiting.
Yeah. He was waiting there for, like, 15 hours. Just that one spot. His manager comes up and he's like, hey, dude, you got to get the whole floor. And he's just like, okay, man.
Oh, shit.
And, like, you know, he's fired and he's still just... She's coming eventually. I didn't need this job. This is a cover-up, man.
Damn, that's pretty in depth. He's good. He's good. I wonder what his name is. Apparently, he's not. What do they call him? The White Portuguese or whatever?
Oh, no.
That's not what he was.
I think that dude. I read he was actually.
He was Russian, is what he was.
Yeah, he was. That's the KG Beast.
Yes. Yes. Actually, Kevin Smith said something about that. He thinks that might have been the KG Beast.
Yeah.
Yeah, I forgot all about that. You're right. I mean, he might have been, but they didn't.
Yeah, like, I. They didn't, it's like, one of those things, like, you. They just kind of throw away characters like that. Because the CIA agent at the beginning of the movie, I believe, was supposed to be Jimmy Olsen.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I remember reading about that, too.
You know, that was Superman's little fuckboy. Like how Robin was to Batman. That was Superman's little pansy boy, you know?
For sure.
Kept him around.
His little bitch.
I sound like an asshole right now. I need to stop talking like that.
No.
But, no, like, it was just his little sidekick that he kept around, whoever the fuck he was, for whatever reason. And he followed Clark Kent around a lot.
Yeah, he was a photographer.
Yeah.
Jimmy Olsen was.
Yes, he was. For the Daily Planet. See, this is where my ignorance of comic books comes in.
Like, especially, well, I don't know everything, but I know this shit just from, like, documentaries and conversations and shit like that, but. Back in the day, he was like a redhead and shit, had freckles. He was a real dork and shit. Yeah. Like, he pretty much just idolized Clark and, like, followed him around. And,
yeah.
And he eventually got his own comic book.
Oh, did he?
Just called Jimmy Olsen. Yeah, it was The Adventures of Jimmy. And, it, like, he just did, like, normal.
How often did Clark Kent make an appearance?
I don't know. I didn't really read him. But
I think that would be a very interesting comic book to read.
The Jimmy Adventures of Jimmy Olsen. Lois Lane had her own as well.
I don't think I'd care for that too much.
I think it might have been an issue of Lois Lane. She actually got the power. Like, and I can't remember how it was. Maybe she, like, went into some machine or something that Clark had or Superman had. And she changed herself from white to black. And she experienced what it was like to be a black person in that time period. Which was like kind of like a civil rights movement for black people. So it was actually very political and, like, a lot of, it was very, like, highly regarded and shit. But that's crazy. They did crazy shit like that, you know what I mean? That's
Lois
what
Lane
they did
Turner
with, like,
herself.
Jimmy Olsen and Lois Lane.
She's a natural journalist if she did that.
Yeah. Yeah, she's it's like Tyra Banks putting on a fat suit, you know what I mean?
Well, wasn't she her own fat suit for a while?
Tyra Banks?
Yeah, I thought she got pretty big for a while and people were body shaming her.
Maybe,
because she was a supermodel and then she put on a bunch of weight.
Maybe, I didn't know that.
She,
but
was,
I know, this
she,
happened,
was, she
like,
was her own fat suit, I believe.
Years ago, but yeah, could have been.
I'm sorry, Tyra Banks.
Yeah.
I have nothing against you, but you were fat.
He does.
I'm just kidding.
Anyway. We continue to just ramble on about everything but Batman versus Superman. But, so I guess, what were we saying?
No, it's. I feel like it's still entertaining.
No, it is. It definitely is.
I didn't know that about Jimmy Olsen having his own comic book. That still fascinates me.
I think we just need to have a different approach. Like, we should say what we. First off, we should state whether or not we liked the movie.
I very much liked the movie.
I liked the movie, too, especially on my second viewing of it. I liked it on my second viewing more than my first viewing.
I agree. I felt more grounded going into it the second time. The hype was down, you know, like, and I...
Oh, yeah. Yeah, yeah.
Know,
I
got
was,
to finish... I got to sit through it and, you know, relax and actually take the movie in.
Yeah, I didn't feel like I had to just, like, try to notice and... Figure
out
everything.
Watch it the first time, and you're just like,
I didn't have
you know,
to be so critical.
Yeah, what's gonna happen this way? And we're like, you know, what am I gonna miss if I'm not paying that close
exactly.
of attention?
Like, I gotta piss, but I want to wait until this is
exactly.
over. Exactly. You know what I mean,
dude? Like when I was at Star Wars, man, I had to piss the whole time. Mm. I was just waiting for it.
Star Wars, actually got up and pissed twice.
You bastard!
I couldn't help it.
But no, I think I was the same way with Batman vs Superman. Like, I ate all my popcorn and drank all my drink before the trailers were over.
Oh. I gotcha.
As I'm, you know, a chubby bastard, and I'm wont to do.
See, I don't buy treats. Oh, maybe I'll buy something to drink sometimes or popcorn. Usually, I'll get Emily popcorn if I go to the theater. But usually, I'm that guy that just fucking like puts shit in her purse and we get it out.
Well, yeah, man.
There, we'll light
I don't carry a purse though. I go by
That's
myself.
True. That's true. But like, I used to put shit in my hoodie and whatnot. Like, they don't really search you anymore.
No, but.
I guess now they are.
Yeah, they might start searching you now because...
They listen to my podcast.
Yeah, they're like, oh, this son of a bitch.
Well, now we know.
They let the guys with the AK-47s walk past while they're searching you for candy.
Yeah, you're
just
absolutely
like, no,
right.
I'll fight outside food and drink, homeboy.
Yeah. Just don't put... Well, they should get metal detectors, and I just won't put my shit in metal objects. But yes, we enjoyed the movie. We give it a thumbs up. Now, what did we not like about the movie? Or what did we not so much understand, like or not understand about the movie?
Honestly, it's just some parts were a little corny. That was it.
A little corny? Like what?
The Martha thing. That was very corny. Yeah. Even though it's not that it was random or anything, and it wasn't like, you know, he randomly heard Martha and was like, oh my God, you know, like, they build up to it.
Yeah.
But it was still corny. It was, like, Batman being the stubborn guy he is, I don't think he would have listened to any other kind of reason. Like, he just hated Superman.
See, I don't think it would have been so corny if it wasn't the reason they stopped fighting.
Yeah.
Like, that's what made it corny to me. In any others, like, less dramatic or, like, angry, violent situation, where these guys were just beating the shit out of each other, like, I fucking hate you, you need to die, I fucking hate you. Like, Batman was ready to kill this motherfucker.
Yeah, he was. He was about to.
Like, he's about to kill a motherfucker that's supposedly unkillable, and your mom's name is Martha, too?
Yeah.
And now you're just not. You just cut this motherfucker with it. Like, you cut. And they answered the question of, do you bleed?
Yeah, yeah.
When
well,
you
I know
did
that.
Not bleed.
Yeah, I figured that's what that was. Like, you know, in the trailer when he's like, you know, do you bleed? You will.
Yeah.
And I think when he whispered that after Superman took off, I think he knew Superman could probably still hear him.
Yeah. For sure. I think Superman. They showed you in the movie that Superman was hearing, like, everything.
Yeah, because he was hearing Alfred talk to him.
Yeah,
he was walking through the mansion.
Yeah, the Bluetooth or whatever.
I really liked Jeremy Irons as Alfred.
Yeah, me too. He has, like, how, real wisdom and,
yeah,
like...
I like how, like, you know, bitter he was. Like, Alfred really is about... Every one of them really gets that, like, bitter old man who wants his houseboy to grow up and be married and have a normal life, but he's stuck with... raising a vigilante.
Yeah.
No, it's like when he's just like, yeah, maybe you'll find a nice woman. And he's like, oh, yeah, Alfred, in your dreams.
Yeah.
I still, Michael Caine is my favorite Alfred, though.
For sure. He seemed the most Alfred-like.
Yeah.
And I just liked the version of Alfred that Jeremy Irons brought to the table. It was more like a... Like, when your dad's your kind of, like, sidekick. Like, your right-hand man. You know what I mean? That's kind of what it was.
What do I know about dads being sidekicks? I hope, like, Jeremy Irons' Alfred is going to be, like, more physical.
Oh, like maybe gets a little involved. That'd be cool.
That might be another reason why they got someone more fit and, like, you know, it wasn't kind of like, nothing against Michael Caine. He wasn't a fat old dude or anything, but he was a fat old dude.
Yeah, like he, it like wouldn't be believable. Like he could potentially get into some shit and Batman has to go do some shit. That makes no sense. Very general what I just said.
Yeah.
But I think you kind of get the picture. Like there's potential for him to get in the way of things. You know what I mean? Like, he was kind of, like, always bringing him down. Like, what are you doing? Like, you're getting your ass kicked. This Alfred, Jeremy Irons Alfred, is just like, let's fucking get him. Kill the motherfuckers. You know what I mean? Just kill them. Because he's killing everybody.
Yeah, he's already just as much tired of it as...
Yeah, they have the same mindset. They're both on the same page. That's what I dig about it.
Yeah. Like, you know, they're tired of fucking fighting all these dumbass criminals who just get out of prison and do the same stupid shit.
Yeah.
Even though Batman's just kind of an asshole who's, you know, thinks it's his duty to go around kicking people's asses.
Yeah, killing them. Like, they tried to...
You're selling weed in the park! Son of a bitch!
Well, I mean...
My parents were killed by a guy who wanted their pearls.
You're right, though. He wanted their fucking pearls.
Like, I kind of want to read a story from the citizens' perspective of Gotham, you know, like, what I liked about The Dark Knight Returns was, you know, like, the girl who became the new Robin. Like, okay, her parent, yeah, her parents were like hippies, and they kept, you know, talking about how Batman was a fucking fascist and all this and that, and I really like that. Like, they show that perspective of some of the society, like
the politics behind it.
Yeah, like a lot of people are just fed up with him, just like, he's just an asshole going around like doling out. It's not even justice, because he's judge, jury, and executioner.
Yeah,
you know?
he's more Punisher like or anything. Like,
he's the Punisher that doesn't kill. Like, even at least Frank Castle admits that what he's doing is shitty.
Yeah, no,
he's
for
just
sure.
tired of it too. You know,
but yeah, no, he definitely.
Sometimes Batman's just up his own ass, and he's like, I just don't want to kill, you know, because I'm just like them. It's like, you're still just like them.
Yeah.
You're a criminal, too.
They even stated in Batman vs. Superman, where he's like, we're criminals, too, Alfred. Like, basically, that's what he said. He's like, dude, we're doing the same shit they are.
Yeah.
We're just doing it in a different way, kind of.
He feels like he's helping more. And he kind of is. Like, he's not like he's...
He's like the Boondock Saints version of Batman.
Yeah.
Just kill those motherfuckers. Like, just get rid of them. Unless they are fear me, motherfucker.
I mean, that's how he was in The Dark Knight Returns, though. You know, which was a huge influence for that Batman.
Oh, definitely, down to the suit.
That was that's my favorite bat suit so far.
Oh, no doubt, no doubt. That's been my favorite bat suit like for a while.
I didn't really care for the Michael Keaton one. The 1960s one, I didn't like,
It wasn't. It was a costume, is what that shit was. But I mean, it's the cowl was sweet though.
Yeah,
I dug like the they had actually had like designs painted on it, and shit. Or just like different colors to it.
What do you mean in the Batman vs Superman one?
No, in the 1966 Batman.
Oh yeah, like, it was like stitched.
That's what I like about it. Like, I'd like to own that and like have it displayed. You know?
Yeah,
I mean?
That'd be cool.
But no, I see what you're saying.
But I can't get behind any of the ones that Joel Schumacher made, because, like, then it just became, like, making an anatomically correct bat suit.
Well,
why do the criminals need to see how ripped Batman is?
No, for sure.
I highly doubt George Clooney was that ripped.
The Batman Forever bat suit wasn't terrible, but
no.
George Clooney's bat suit was awful. It's like the fucking toys you see at the dollar store, dude, where Batman's just painted up. It's like, he took it to a fucking graffiti artist. Was just like, fucking airbrush all this shit or something. Like, well, it was all metal and metallic and shit, but it's just like... Like, you ever see those, like, dollar store fucking DC or Marvel toys? That's what it looked like. It looked like one of those.
I think there's a level of camp, you know, intended in those ones. Like, because he didn't immediately jump into it being super campy in the
Batman Forever was serious. Was so pretty much serious.
But, like, the Riddler was the more campy parts to it.
But I don't think it was intended, you know what I mean?
I think it was, like, because Joel Schumacher wanted that, I'm pretty sure. He wanted to make it more like the 1960s ones, but he kept it going along the same lines as what Tim Burton already laid down, you know?
Yeah, in that same, like, realm.
Where it was dark and... But it was still campy. It was dark and campy.
Oh, especially, yeah, the villains especially.
Yeah, like... I really liked Tommy Lee Jones as Two-Face.
Yeah, for sure.
He was awesome.
It's like they were both trying to out-camp each other, though. It's like they were both like, I want to be Jack Nicholson. No, I want to be Jack Nicholson. And like, they were basically... I don't know, they were just... Like, Riddler, I can understand being that charismatic, kind of.
Yeah.
Two-Face is a little more angry.
Yeah.
Not so...
Yeah, he's a little more
antisocial. More like, fuck you.
He's more of a gangster, you know? He takes what he wants. He doesn't give a shit.
Yeah.
And that's how Tommy Lee Jones is. That's how people view him. He's man of the house.
I read a story that Tommy Lee Jones and Jim Carrey fucking hated each other during that.
Like, it's probably because Jim Carrey was always talking with his anus.
That could have been.
They're at table reads, and Jim Carrey just bends over and starts talking with his ass, and Tommy Lee Jones, being the serious guy he is like, what the fuck? I'm man of the house.
Your Tommy Lee Jones impression is spot on.
I'm sure he's probably going to listen to that and be like, I didn't do a cameo in that.
Yeah, you did, Tommy. Remember? You're getting old,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, man. You came and you signed an affidavit and everything. We did a whole hour-long episode of Tommy Lee Jones signing his affidavit.
That would be amazing. That would be Tommy Lee Jones on, but having you just pretend to be Tommy Lee Jones the whole episode. That would be fantastic.
We might work our way towards that someday.
Shit. But yeah, we're the best at getting off the subject.
Yeah. They're relevant tangents. It's not like we just go off.
No, I'm not. I'm not complaining. I like it. I'm enjoying it. I'm just saying. Yeah.
But
things we didn't like about the movie.
What do you like about Wonder Woman? Do you like Wonder Woman?
I liked Wonder Woman. I think she did a good job. They never actually called her Wonder Woman in the movie, though. They did show her symbol.
Yeah.
But they...
I really hope...
I don't even think they called her Diana at all.
They... when she's leaving the plane, the one woman's like, Miss Prince.
Yeah.
That's really the only allusion to her name you get. But I really hope they go with a storyline where when Wonder Woman joins the Justice League, she joins as their secretary.
Really?
Yeah. Even,
I doubt that they'll do that.
No, I hope they do. Come on, Zack Snyder, piss everybody off.
He might. He was actually quoted as saying that Justice League was going to be more fun and not so grim, because that's kind of what Justice League is.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
It's going to be more like an Avengers movie.
I think so. It'll still...
I don't think it'll it won't be as Avengers. Dark as, I don't think it'll be as dark as Batman vs. Superman.
No.
Because all of the characters will be involved in, like...
Yeah, they're not all dark and
the
grim.
The Flash is... He's a sarcastic dude. Sometimes Hal Jordan's pretty sarcastic.
Yeah.
I liked Green Lantern in Justice League War, when like him and Batman just kept
just
getting
cracking
into their little
jokes.
Yeah,
that was good. He made a lot of like modern pop culture references and shit, which I enjoyed.
Yeah.
Although I wouldn't be surprised if it was fairly dark, because they even made Superman dark, and that dude was pretty much the day to Batman's night.
Yeah.
He was the Batman of the day, the good Batman.
Yeah, Superman's usually just a more lighthearted stories.
Yeah, like it's real.
It's all about hope and
exactly. Like it's.
But you can be.
They're adventures.
You can have hope in the
you know
dark,
what I mean?
Homeboy.
No, you can.
That's where hope is most valuable.
That's where hope probably exists most. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But or maybe not. Maybe I'm wrong. What do I know? Lex Luthor. How'd you feel about Lex Luthor?
Still sticking to my opinion, he was a little more on the Joker side.
Yeah.
I think he's going to be a little more grounded in the next one. Like, he realizes, like, I think he's come to terms with the fact that he was too arrogant. Like, he thought he had everything figured out, and then shit didn't go his way.
Yeah. Yeah, I think he kind of jumped into things a little too much. Like,
Yeah, like, I mean, if the Joker just does it because he knows nothing ever goes right.
Well, the problem, because I still kind of do. I have a problem with the Lex Luthor in this movie. This is one of the things I don't like about the movie. And I still kind of don't.
Yeah.
One of the few things I dislike about this movie is the portrayal of Lex Luthor in the movie. They didn't actually state it, but they imply it when he talks about his father in the movie. He describes...
Being the Lex behind the corp?
Yes. He was the Lex behind the corp, which, if you know, I believe his father's name was... what was his fucking name? I can't remember. It wasn't Lex.
Yeah.
I know that. And, Lionel Luthor.
Yeah.
Was his father's name, and He said he was the Lex behind the corp. There's no Lex in Lionel. And the way he described his father sounded nothing like Lex Luthor. So obviously this Lex Luthor is the Lex Luthor that he's supposed to be. The guy, like, his father wasn't trying to fucking get Superman, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
His father wasn't Lex Luthor. This is the
Lex
Luthor
Jr., but it's the Lex Luthor that's meant for Superman.
Yeah, like, it's the same Lex Luthor, he's just
different story. Like,
it's weird. I it's hard to explain. You know what I mean?
Well, I mean, he is a lot younger.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure he's probably mid-20s or something like that.
Maybe they're just changing his origin a little bit.
Batman's, what, like 50?
Yeah. Well, yeah.
The storylines are all really weird, like, with what they're trying to do, but...
Because I think Superman's even, like, 30-something.
They're trying to make certain, you know, make sense of it all. But I'm just really curious, like... Because, you know, he's not just going to use Flashpoint Paradox to tell that story.
Oh, no. He's not even going to do Flashpoint Paradox. He's just going to take gonna be a as much as he wants from it.
Flashpoint Paradox. Yeah. Like, there might be... I mean, I heard people talking about... I saw shit about people talking about an Injustice, you know, storyline. Because you remember...
No, I've heard
you remember when Superman catches Batman and rips the mask off and he's, like, you know, pissed because Lois is dead... And now he's, like, ruler of the world.
Yes. Mm-hmm. That's why he's
like,
all... Yeah,
I mean, in Injustice, he's pissed about that. You know, like, the Joker killed Lois, and he blamed Batman, so he became supreme ruler of the world.
Yeah. Yes.
And I'm pretty sure there's, like, divided timelines in that one, too, I believe.
Oh,
like
yeah. That
parallel universe.
In Injustice?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. That's the whole thing. Like, they go to a parallel timeline in which...
Where Lois didn't die.
Yeah, like, even good guys are, like, bad.
Yeah.
And you're fighting, like, the good guy version of a character is fighting the bad guy version of a character and shit, like...
Yeah, that one's almost like Crisis on Two Earths and Flashpoint Paradox.
So, yeah, I guess I didn't think of it like that. Maybe this is just a different universe. And, yeah. Like, I don't know why I wouldn't think of it like that, considering the multiverse is hugely popular in DC.
Yeah.
But, okay, that would explain... The Lex thing, because that's... I had a big problem with them. But maybe, like I said, they're just changing Lex's origin a little bit. And now, because at the end of the movie, like we saw, he shaves his head and everything. Like I even read or watched one review where they talked about maybe Lex is like a disciple of Darkseid. Maybe okay. He's like in being controlled. Like, because... That would just explain, because they never really... Like, why... Why is Lex doing anything he's doing in the movie?
Yeah.
What does he have against Superman, really? Other than... Really, they don't tell you anything. I can't tell you why Lex is doing any of the shit he's doing.
Well,
I'm hoping...
Well, I mean, he's a super smart dude, first and foremost. Like, I mean, he's, like, one of the most intelligent people on the Earth in this storyline. And he knows about the metahumans... Because he's got files on Wonder Woman, Flash, and Cyborg.
No.
And Aquaman. And he probably has more files that he has hidden somewhere where he knows about Darkseid. Because he kept talking about the demons coming from the skies above.
No, that's why I feel like he's probably... Yeah. He's motivated by Darkseid.
Like, he knows Darkseid exists. And I don't know, maybe he thinks if he could try to kill Superman, he could try to stop Darkseid from coming.
No, I honestly, I've thought these things already,
yeah.
And but they anybody who doesn't know anything, this is why it's getting such bad reviews. Anybody who doesn't know anything about any of this stuff has no fucking idea what's going on in this movie. This movie is made for people who read comics. This movie is a comic.
Like, you have to have some knowledge prior to watching.
Well, even the way it's cut, like, it's pretty much. You could basically watch this movie and just picture that as a panel in a comic book. Like, exactly what you're seeing. Like, just moving. Like, that's what Zack Snyder is great at. I keep pointing at the television. There's nothing on it, but that's what Zack Snyder is great at. He is a fantastic cinematographer. He can make things look fucking awesome, but he does not know how to tell a story through pictures, dude. That's like...
Yeah.
The best story he told... that I've ever seen is Watchmen. And even that was a little choppy. You know what I mean? Like, without knowing what the Watchmen are, like, a lot of people probably don't like that movie because of it. That movie got a lot of shit.
I love that movie.
Me too, man. And the director's cut's even better. Like, that's why I'm looking forward to the director's cut of this. They're coming out with the rated R version.
I heard it's going to be released in theaters, possibly.
Yes, I read about that, too. That would be cool.
That'll be my third viewing, then.
That would
be 3 hours of Batman vs. Superman, rated R. Thank you.
For sure. For sure. Thank I'm gonna buy it on Blu-ray and shit. I'm hoping. And rated R. There's not going to be any fucking... There might be an F-bomb or something, but, like, there's not going to be any worse language. You're not going to be seeing titties
or anything.
No,
I hope in this version, in every tense moment, Batman's just screaming, "Fuck!"
Did you see that Cracked video?
No.
Somebody edited that whole Batman fight scene where this is what they thought the rated R version would be. And it's literally, like, he's doing that. He's like, "Fuck your mother!" Like, every time he's like...
"God damn it!"
And he, at one point, he was just like, "Fuck!" But, like, as he's jumping, he's like, "Fuck you." But,
like, the
even...
Scene, the scene where he's exercising and he's dropping the weights, he's like, "God, fuck it!"
Well, no, this was just the fight scene, yeah. That badass fight scene. But even when the fucking, like, Warner Brothers logo and, like, whatever the other symbol is that comes up, like, Warner Brothers logo. Blood splatter. Fucking whatever production company logo. Blood splatter. Like, they would just throw blood anywhere. Just anywhere. Like, that's what they think it's going to be. And that's very well what it could be, but I doubt it.
It'd probably be more Batman killing and everyone, "No, Batman doesn't kill."
Well, I'm hoping...
Dude, I was just reading
it's more than that.
Yeah.
I'm hoping you're seeing more of, like... Like, how did Lex actually make Darkseid?
Doomsday?
Yeah, that's what I mean. Doomsday, my bad. And I just want to see more story. I'm hoping that's what it is.
I would like a little more background on...
Because they're adding like 31 minutes or 30 minutes to the movie, something like that. Which, that's a lot. That's enough to change the entire movie.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know if you've ever saw the, like, 4-hour versions of the Lord of the Rings movies.
Yeah, I have.
Those are way different movies. Some scenes are completely different. Like, there's a scene...
They're just way longer.
Yeah, which is still awesome. But at one point in Return of the King, you actually see Merry and Pippin, like, smoking weed and getting drunk. Like, they're stoned as fucking, you can tell. And they're wasted, dude. It's awesome.
I fucking love hobbits, man. That's all they do is smoke and drink.
Then they were just smashing food and shit. Like, it was great. Yeah, I'm looking forward to the rated R version. They've been releasing movies super quick after their... Like, 4 months after they've been in theaters, they're fucking... Deadpool comes out May 10th. Star Wars came out last week.
Oh, shit.
Yeah,
oh,
I have, dude. I bought it. There's a fucking full-length documentary on the making of it. It's awesome. Totally worth the $24 I paid for it, dude. For that documentary alone.
Yeah.
But... Target exclusive, you get cool packaging and shit. Extra bonus content.
Abrams was only doing that movie, right?
Just the first one, yeah. The guy who, I believe his name is Colin Trevorrow, or maybe it's a different guy. No, I think it's Rian Johnson, or Rian Johnson. He made something that was pretty good. I can't remember. But Colin Trevorrow's making the third one, or episode 9.
Mm-hmm.
That's the guy that made Jurassic World.
So it's going to suck.
I think that's also the guy who made Chronicle. Did you ever see Chronicle?
No.
Chronicle's a good movie. Kids get superpowers from...
I remember people...
Telekinesis or whatever.
One.
That's a good movie, dude. Max Landis, the guy
I'll
who wrote
it to
kind
the
of
list.
A dick.
What is it?
Chronicle.
No, would you say somebody being a dick?
Oh, Max Landis, the guy who wrote it. Well, he's not really a dick, but he's kind of, like, opinionated, and I don't agree with a lot of the shit he says. Like, he didn't like Star Wars. Like, he bashed the shit out of the new Star Wars movie. He's probably bashed the shit out of Batman vs. Superman, too.
Yeah, because Chronicle is better.
Chronicle was good, though, man. They need to make a sequel, and the sequel he pitched on a podcast, I heard, sounds awesome, and they're not going to make it. He said they'll never make it.
Why doesn't he kickstart it?
That's a good point. I don't know. He writes big movies, though. Like, his movies are... He wrote a couple movies that I didn't even know he wrote, and they were, like, really big movies.
I bet if he was like, "I need $3 million to get this movie started," and a lot of people like you would be like, "All right, I'll give him $20.
Nah, maybe.
And then he gets $3 million from everybody giving him $20.
Hell, it could definitely happen. He's popular enough.
What kind of socialist society is this? Actually, really like. I was watching Flashpoint Paradox earlier, and I really liked how Barack Obama was in the movie. Like, I don't think he played himself, but Cyborg was talking to the president, and it was Barack Obama.
It was actually his voice and shit?
It wasn't his voice. It was somebody trying to sound like him.
But it was definitely Barack Obama.
They just kept saying Mr. President, but you, I mean.
Barack Obama's actually been in a comic book, in a Marvel one. He was in Spider-Man.
Is that when he was teaching Spider-Man about how to accept people who litter and not to sling them up in their webs?
Maybe.
I'm making this up.
I was about to say, I didn't read it, so that couldn't really be enough. I don't know what
it's about. I think he's teaching Spider-Man a lesson of some kind. I don't know. Maybe he's telling him how responsible he is for saving everyone in the world. He's sitting him on his knee, and he's like, now, Spidey, a lot of lives rest in your hands, homeboy. And Spider-Man's like, I'm only 15.
He's being Uncle Ben.
Yeah.
With great power and great responsibility.
Now you can't let us die, man. I need you to.
My bad, I've been holding.
I need you to protect my family.
Jesus, it's a very cheesy comic.
Now Spider-Man is head of national security and the Secret Service. He controls all of them. They're all just spiders in black suits.
You're taking this really far, man.
Back to Batman vs. Superman.
Yeah.
Let's talk about Cyborg. I'm super excited about that.
Yeah, what'd you think?
That was the block thing, I think. That was another nod to Darkseid being in the Justice League movie, I believe. No. I can't remember what it's called.
Me neither. But,
but sure, it's the reason why Cyborg is who he is.
That movie was fucking full of Easter eggs or setups.
That's all it was.
That's pretty much what this movie
was.
It's
priming you for Justice League.
Yeah. That's really, that's what this was. They pulled a phase one in one movie. Pretty much.
Yeah. Fast track.
Yep. Which, I guess in the long run, I think
first we'll start out with three superheroes, and then we'll throw three more in.
Yeah, exactly.
And then by the third movie, we'll have nine superheroes in a movie.
Bum bum bum.
We'll beat Marvel in six movies.
Boom.
Marvel's trying to get. I think I read Marvel's trying to fit 27 main characters in one film by the end of the ninth Avengers movie.
I think I read that as well. That sounds insane. Insane.
Pretty soon a movie's just going to be a bunch of superheroes walking around buying coffee.
Yeah, it's going to be Superbia.
I don't know why, like, if the world was full of superheroes, would they always wear their superhero costume? Or would you just dress normal because you already know that everyone's a superhero?
That's a very good question. And
you don't have to hide your identity.
You wouldn't have to, really.
What if just dressing?
It would just be
what
normal.
If just dressing in those costumes was a fetish or something?
like for like, superheroes?
Yeah, like it's a super. It's they're all normal. They dress, you know, slacks and t-shirts. They dress casual. They're not wearing superhero costumes all the time because everyone has superpowers.
Well, technically,
it's almost like a utopia, but. Nobody has to hide their identity because everyone knows who everyone is. Like, everyone knows you're a superhero.
Yeah.
Like, there's other reasons to hide your identity, I guess, if you're doing illegal deals in the black market. If everyone has different superpowers, there's a different world, but.
Well, if everybody has superpowers. Do you really have superpowers? That's just part of
your. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Yeah, it's not like you're. It to us, I'm saying it's a superpower.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But. You know, for them, it's an average day. Yeah, that's why they don't wear superhero costumes to hide their identity.
So really, just wearing superhero costumes would
just it's, be like, it'd be like how people in our universe are like guys that like wearing women's underwear.
Exactly, it'd be like cross-dressing or like...
Yeah, that's all. It'd just be a weird...
Or just putting on a costume.
It's just something that people like to do.
Yeah.
Like in the privacy of their home.
Yeah.
Or in public, I don't know. Maybe they'll have superhero conventions there.
It'd be like cosplay. You're creating a character.
Or if they all wear superhero costumes and they go to cosplay, where their comic books are all about people who work in a donut shop or
the normal thing.
This is the adventure, adventures of Circle K.
The adventures of Circle K.
The tales of Speedway.
Damn. Why are you sticking to like gas stations and shit?
I'm like, loving it. The story of McDonald's. And these are like books and influencing their culture. They're aspiring to be normal.
there's no fiction because the world is so crazy. Everything is just like very straight. It's about a world in which you have to get up and work the 9 to 5. Like, that's interesting to them. What would that be like?
Yeah, what would it be like if you couldn't fly to work every day?
I don't know.
What would it be like if you couldn't shoot laser beams out of your eyeballs? I imagine there'd be some form of evolution where everyone has different types of powers. You know, not everyone's going to be like exactly the same.
Maybe your priorities would change. You know what I mean? Like, maybe working and stuff wouldn't even be a factor in your life. Because, I mean, you could just go, like, do shit. You know what I mean? Like, maybe...
Well, it's a utopia, man. Everyone helps each other.
All right. Well, then,
we all just... Wouldn't it just be like paradise? Each other for everything. Yeah. That's what paradise is superheroes.
Well, just being able to do, like, anything you really wanted. Just straight-up freedom. Wouldn't that be paradise? Just like you have everything you need in a beautiful location and shit, and just.
Wow. So, what are you hoping for from Suicide Squad?
Suicide Squad. Well, I don't really know what I'm hoping for. I'm hoping to like Jared Leto's portrayal of the Joker. That's what I'm hoping.
I'm hoping Deathstroke at least has a cameo.
That would be awesome. I doubt it. But that
would be. Well, I heard they were trying to cast for him. That's what I got hope for.
Really? I didn't hear that.
Yeah.
When was
Joe Manganiello or something like that?
Oh, okay. Maybe I did hear about this.
Yeah. I really like the dude that was in Arrow who played Deathstroke.
Yeah,
I really liked that. That kept me interested in the first couple seasons. I still need to watch more. Second season
was my favorite one because of Deathstroke. But Arrow's a good show.
They better make a Green Arrow movie. I wonder if they're going to add the Martian Manhunter.
That's what I was wondering.
Or Hawkman.
They were saying, like, have you ever watched Lost?
Yeah.
You know that weird, thin, black dude that was, like, pushing Locke around when he was in his wheelchair for a while? They were talking about him being Martian Manhunter. That dude would be slick as Martian Manhunter. He even talks like Martian Manhunter.
Yeah.
He's all, like, thin and lengthy and tall and shit. Just paint him up green and shit. Put that fucking...
Or the guy who played Gus in Breaking Bad.
He'd be good. He would be good. Like...
Giancarlo Esposito.
Wow. That was perfectly executed. You could have put a tongue roll in there, probably, but...
No, I'm not... I like to keep it simple, you know?
No, you pulled it off.
I'm not fancy. Batman Beyond. They better do a Batman Beyond movie. That just came to my brain.
I feel like... DC's probably going to try to play it as safe as possible from here on out. Not really safe, but like, they're probably not going to try to invest so much into so many different things right now.
Yeah.
Kind of like what Marvel was like a success from the start. Because they completely
appealed to, Iron Man was the first one in that, right?
I believe so. Well, technically, the Incredible Hulk movie was, because there was
I thought that came out after Iron Man.
No, I think that introduced Robert Downey Jr. as Iron Man in the end credit scene. Pretty sure.
Look it up.
I should.
Search it. Search it, bring it, babe.
M-dib.
Bust it, search it, bring it, babe. I don't know what the lyrics to that song were. Oops, I smacked the microphone.
May 2nd, 2008, Iron Man came out.
Yeah, I believe the Hulk came out like August or something like that.
June.
Yeah.
June 13th. So you're right. All right, I guess I was wrong. So I thought he hadn't established yet, and they were just like, holy shit.
Brett's always right. No, just kidding.
Apparently, yeah. In this instance, he's always right.
No, I'm just teasing. Until
I can prove otherwise.
But, yeah, like, what? It went, I'm just trying to think, it went Iron Man, Hulk. Was Captain America before Iron Man 2 or after?
Captain America was after Iron Man 1. No. It might have been after 2.
That movie was fucking boring.
Iron Man 2?
No, Captain America, First Avenger.
Yeah, that movie was kind of boring.
That was the most boring fucking piece of shit.
Well, most of it wasn't relevant.
I couldn't afterwards. Handle watching it. I did not want to see a movie where Captain America was a fucking sideshow act.
To who?
Wasn't he always doing those plays, talking about, you know, being a good soldier and all that shit?
Oh, like in them, yeah, for like the troops and shit like that. And like, yeah.
He wasn't really a soldier at that point.
No, you're right. He wasn't. He had training in the military, but
yeah,
like,
no, he was a militant, but he wasn't in the military to be a soldier. They pretty much made him a sideshow freak.
No, for sure. There's probably like, just the good 45 minutes of the movie, he wasn't fucking Captain America at all. Even when he was Captain America, he wasn't being Captain America. Not only that, but pretty much that whole movie took place in the 1940s. So,
yeah, that's awkward.
Nothing really happened. Like, what did he do that was really like Captain America in that movie?
He ran very fast.
Yeah, but I mean, like, fight
he did that in the Avengers. He ran very fast.
Yeah,
I felt like that was his superpower for most of his career.
He could punch hard and shit.
But for the most part, they just showed him running very fast.
You're right. Ripping car doors off and like using it as. Yeah, he really doesn't have a fucking superpower. He's just like a big. Tough guy that can run real fast.
He's
punch real hard.
Yeah, more Superman. Human than human.
Wow, nice Rob Zombie reference. But he's pretty much Superman, just dialed down a notch and can't fly.
Yeah,
never really thought about that.
Super Soldier Serum.
Yeah, man.
I just remember the first one. Like every time they kept showing him, he was running really fast. That's all I remembered about the movie. And then I started watching Winter Soldier, and it just started, the movie pretty much started out with him running track. And I was like, what the fuck?
Yeah.
But from what I hear, it's way better, and it started out like the sequence on the ship was way better. Honestly, that whole sequence was way better than the first one, in my opinion.
Yeah. I really enjoyed the second one, though. Winter Soldier.
Yeah, I have to finish it.
Oh, all right. You haven't even finished that shit?
No, I got...
It's been out for like a couple years.
I know.
But I guess we should probably wrap up the Batman vs. Superman talk, and then we can just go on.
What? Oh, yeah. Let's go. Let's finish like, talking what? I forgot we were talking about Batman vs. Superman.
Yeah, we were talking about...
We keep going on so many tangents.
It's all good,
but though. this is just movie review today. Let's not call it the Batman vs. Superman review.
I guess, yeah.
The movie talk.
Movie talk. With
centralized around Batman vs. Superman. That was the inspiration.
Yeah.
But that seed sprouted so many little seedlings.
Seedlings. I feel like talk is too general. Like movie rant. Or
yes, movie rant.
Because we're just kind of like just ranting on. Ramble. Movie ramble.
Movie talk, too. I mean, it's so relevant.
It's, yeah. You're right.
Just talking about movies. We started with Batman vs. Superman. Now we're talking about movies.
Talking about movies.
Meta talk. That's our, what is it? Talking Dead.
Yes.
That'll be our Talking Dead is meta talk. We'll talk about the talk.
Meta talk.
It'll be immediately after the talk. We'll stop that one and we'll be like, all right, Brett, so how do you think the show went? Well, Mark, I feel like I could have done a little better here, and then it's a post show.
A post show on the show. I like it. So we will
give people the real behind the scenes.
Yeah.
What's it like being Brett and Mark?
But what part is behind the scenes? Right now when we're talking about it?
Yeah.
Or the part afterwards?
Oh, man.
Yeah, it's a paradox, bro.
Because right? We are kind of, we're talking about it, but it hasn't happened yet. But we're still talking about it.
Bum, bum, bum. Is it even going to happen?
I actually really like that when Lex Luthor was like on stage and he's just like, because that's just paradoxical. I actually laughed both times when I saw that.
I get to stay on that. I feel like his character's going to have a huge shift from here on out. Like, he's not going to be like he was in this movie.
Oh, hell no.
I feel like maybe this one, like, because there was always like a depiction of Lex before he lost his hair and shit before, and he was a much very different person, kind of. Yeah. So I think maybe we'll see him more like Lex in the coming films. You know what I mean?
Well, I think with him being like, because he didn't really lose his hair, they just shaved his head.
Yeah, yeah.
And I think being the person he is, he's going to look at it as being born as a new person, yeah, almost. Mm-hmm. So, and like, that's, he's just going to keep that as a reminder of who to keep being. Like, yeah, this is who you need to be. This is what you need to do. You made so many mistakes in the past.
A baptism of sorts.
Yeah.
I bet you $5 he even refers to it as a baptism in the movie.
On the movie talk thing, what is going on with the Amory Wars movie?
Dude, I have not heard shit.
What the friggin' frig?
Pretty much, this is what I think happened with that. For anybody that doesn't know, Amory Wars is the comic created by the singer of the prog rock band Coheed and Cambria. I'm sure you've heard me talk about him before. And it was bought by Mark Wahlberg's company Leverage quite a few years ago. I would almost say 5, maybe 6 years ago.
Yeah.
Maybe longer.
Yeah.
Now,
a while ago.
And an option to be made a film, and it's been speculated whether or not it would be a full-length feature live-action film or an animated film, which I think they should make an animated film first.
Why?
Unless they're going to put the money it deserves into the live-action film.
It is Marky Mark. He's got a lot of that money from when he was an underwear model. And he's got the burger show now.
Yeah, yeah. He's got that Entourage movie money.
Yeah.
Walt! Cut it out, dickhole.
Yeah, you bastard.
And,
he can front that money just for that movie.
Not only he get his brother Donnie in on, he's got that New Kids on the Block money, yo.
Yeah.
They're touring again, man. He seems like he's doing good. He's married to Jenny McCarthy and shit. And like, she's still hot and somewhat relevant. And he's been in Beast movies. Sixth Sense and shit.
He's in The Sixth Sense?
Donnie Wahlberg was.
I've never actually watched that movie.
Oh. He was the skinny, weird guy in the beginning that shoots him. He was in Dreamcatcher.
Okay, yeah, he was.
The weird, retarded. Yeah, the weird, orange-looking kid.
No more.
He's an alien.
Mr. Gay.
He was in the Saw movies.
Yeah, I don't think he was in all of them. He was only in, like, two of them.
Two of them. Because in the one, his son
he survives
was, like,
through
kidnapped.
One, and then he dies in the next one, I believe.
I don't think I saw past the one his kid was kidnapped in. Whichever one that was.
I once saw a Saw parody.
Yeah.
And somebody just took an hour and a half footage of a Saw running. I watched the entire thing.
That is insane. You watched the entire thing?
Yeah.
Are you kidding? You're joking. You
Why would I sit through that, Mark?
I don't know, but I didn't want to indulge you if it didn't have a real thing to it.
I think I want to do that, though. I want to try to pass that as an art film.
You should.
Saw the real life.
I bet you at least you could convince one person that it is an art film. At least.
No, maybe there's more. There's lots of tricks to make people think something silly like that. Well, I mean, I wouldn't say silly, but you can convince somebody that something like that is an art film.
I get you. No, I can see that.
I mean, because art's too subjective.
That's true. Art is different to anybody. Like, art can... Nothing.
like how I say Batman vs. Superman is good, and you say Batman vs. Superman is good. We weren't paid to say that by anybody. No. I promise everybody listening to that.
Trust me, we don't get paid to say anything.
No one wants to pay me for my thoughts.
Amen, sister.
That's why, yeah. Except for, unless RC wants to throw me some ducats or some free cola, because their fantastic drink has kept me hydrated through this entire episode.
Dude, I've straight up, they've been like front and center in the camera on Jay and Mark, and I've never gotten anything, so. Good luck with that, though. Let me know if it works out. We can try to do it more.
Yeah, we'll strategically place products in our podcast of audio.
I can, and I will. Until I get some kind of copyright claim.
Do you wish you could have the drink that you hear Brett and Mark slurping on all episode?
RC Cherry Cola. The Royal Crown Cola.
I know you can't see it, but it's sitting on the table between Brett and Mark.
You can hear us open the bottle. I'm pretty sure I got that. That's how crisp it is. You heard it.
I love crisp RC Sola. RC Cola. RC Soda. Cola. Cola
RC,
Sola.
RC Sola. That's Han Solo's daughter.
Han Solo. Fuck that movie. What? I fucking hated Finn.
Yeah, Finn was a
Jesus Christ.
Yes. In Star Wars Episode 7. He was probably my least favorite character.
Yeah, don't listen to this podcast if you're not familiar with some movies.
Yeah. Yeah.
You probably might know more than me, so email Mark and tell him how stupid I am. I don't care.
Yes.
Yes, these are things that'll happen.
I am open to emails.
But no, dude, Finn was just so goddamn annoying. He's just like too self-righteous. Well, you know, he started off, he's like, I don't want to kill, but he like saw, not only did he see how human other, like, the other people are, he also saw how human the stormtroopers were.
Mm-hmm.
When that one died and, like, put that blood mark on his helmet.
Well, the thing about Finn, man, is he's a fucking traitor.
Yeah, he really is.
They stated in the film that they are taken from their families as a child, and then they're all raised together. So he's technically, he left, went to the Resistance, and now he's killing everyone he grew up with.
Yeah.
Like, people he probably knew, people he considered friends, and they considered... That's why that that stormtrooper, they nicknamed TR-8R, which is like traitor.
Yeah.
Because he says, traitor, on that island, and attacks him, and he's got that cool-ass weapon that can, like, fight a lightsaber and shit. Because people are, like, behind him, and it's like, yeah, he was a fucking traitor, like... And technically he was, in that guy's eyes he was. Like, you're killing us, dude, you were one of us.
What the fuck?
Finn... In my eyes, is not to be trusted, man. I mean, he seems innocent.
He's too squeamish.
And he was ready to straight up leave him at one point.
Yeah, he's very assuming when it comes to Rey.
Yeah, I feel like they're gonna hook up.
They probably are, but like at the beginning, he's just he just assumed she wanted him to do everything for her.
Yeah. She wasn't taking, like, no shit from anybody, though. You'd think he would have figured that out. Especially, like, in the first time meeting her, she was beating dudes' asses.
But I'm excited to see the next one.
Me too. Rogue One. Did you see the Rogue One trailer?
No. Let's watch it.
You want to watch
it? Can we watch it?
Yeah. Rogue One. That's right. It looks sweet, man. The Rogue One trailer looks good.
A 3D shot right there.
For sure.
Forrest Whitaker?
Yep. Looks badass.
That movie looks. That I'm becoming a Star Wars fan.
Yeah, dude. They're, I might they're be doing a front runner,
but. Look at him. He's sitting there pissed. He's like, I didn't have to be in the first one. I spent so much time there. I was in it for 15 seconds.
It was like a. Dude, that was like. Especially when I watched it like the second and third time, that part went on for so fucking long.
I'm just here because people need to know that Luke Skywalker still exists.
Shit. He does.
Luke Skywalker's just gonna kill himself.
Is he?
Yeah.
He's gonna jump off that cliff or whatever.
He's gonna look at that girl and be like, I am your father, and then jump off the cliff.
Your face right now, dude. If only you people could see it. What do you mean, you people?
You friggin' people. Get out of here, you people.
What do you mean, you people?
I'm so excited for that Rogue One now.
Yeah, dude, it looks awesome. It looks really good. And it takes place during the original ones, like right before. Like, this movie, I guess, the plot of it is going to be about how they got the plans to destroy the original Death Star in the first movie. So everything looks like it did back then, like in the movie, but it's going to look even better because it's, like, made now in, like, HD and shit. And it's going to be awesome, dude. It's going to be so good. I can't fucking wait.
Who's directing that one?
I do not know. I can look it up, though. Oh, do you know who Mads Mikkelsen is?
Oh, yeah.
He's in it.
Oh, yeah?
Yep.
Where you heel?
And Alan Tudyk. I don't know if you know who he is.
Dude, he played the voice of Superman in Justice League War.
He was Green Lantern once, or Green Arrow.
Oh, shit.
And let him do that guy right there. He was in, like, Firefly. I love that dude. Gareth Edwards is directing Rogue One. He made, he did Godzilla, the new Godzilla, that movie Monsters.
Monsters?
Yeah. But the guy that played Scoot McNairy, the guy who got his fucking legs cut off.
Yeah.
And exploded in Batman vs. Superman. He was in it, and, like, another girl from, like, Australia or something. It was a movie about aliens. They were trying to make it through the like, red zone or whatever, where aliens had taken over the planet or whatever, and this was highly filled with aliens and shit. Yeah. He was trying to get this girl out of there for his boss for money. And you barely ever saw any aliens. It was pretty much just, like, a dramatic, like, psychological type thing, you know what I mean? They, like, kind of fall in love there for a second, but, like, she has a boyfriend. Like, it's very dramatic. It's more like just a drama set in this world. I liked it. For somebody who can get into something like that, it's good. It's a good movie, but a lot of people didn't because, like...
It's called Monsters?
I think it's called Monster. Oh, no, it's called Monsters with an S. But, yeah, I liked it. Wrap it up with our final thoughts on Batman vs. Superman.
And possibly other movies.
Yeah. Yeah, probably. But
I get 12 thumbs up for Batman vs. Superman.
12 thumbs up from Brett, the shitman fart over here.
And 4 thumbs down for the parts I didn't like.
There you go.
So that's a total of 16 thumbs, 12 up, 4 down. What's the ratio? What is that? A quarter? 25% of bad review?
Yeah, okay. There you go.
Yeah. So it's 75% in my eyes.
So no one really knows.
I put that in a very awkward sentence structure.
How many stars do you give it out of 5? Just so people couldn't quite understand that, can have an idea of how that...
I give it 3.7 stars.
3.7 stars out of 5 from Brett the Shitman Fart over here for Batman v Superman.
Exactly, yes.
I'll go ahead and give it... I'll go ahead and give it a solid 4.
4.
Because after my second viewing, my first viewing, I probably would have given it a 3.5.
Yeah.
Solid 3.5.
I think that's what I gave it my first viewing.
Just because I was like, 2. A lot of this was cool on my first viewing. This is what I thought. A lot of this was cool. I liked a lot of it, but there was just as much I didn't. That if I didn't like it, I at least didn't know how I felt about it. People were asking me the next day at work, like, well, what'd you think? I was like, I don't know how I feel about it quite yet. I went home that night and watched it again. Downloaded an HD cam version of it, and illegally, of course, but
oh my god. I'm making a citizen's arrest right now.
Oh, I'm cutting this out, goddammit. And watched it again, and after that viewing, I give it a solid 4. Because I get it a little more. I see it for what it is, and I see what they were trying to do with it. And I dig it, I just don't think they quite pulled it off. And I don't know why they did certain things the way they did, but solid 4 just because I enjoyed a lot of it. It showed me a lot of things I really wanted to see for a long time. And really, I feel like they could have gave us a little more story.
A little more story. You hear that, Zack Snyder? More story in the next Justice League.
Not really story, just explain what you're doing. Like, make it a... I don't know.
Put subtitles on the screen.
No, I don't know. Just...
This is where Batman has a great revelation. That's what you should write on the screen.
All right, I'm not asking him to spell this shit out for me. All I'm saying is...
No, I get you. Like,
they need to develop characters a little more. Like,
and they need to at least tell you why things are happening. In the next ones.
No,
Superman never develops much more character beyond I'm a human... I'm not human, but I look human, and I can't handle that because I'm not human. I'm such an alien.
I understand that, but
what a fucking asshole! Come to this planet, take our jobs, put our heroes out of business. Firemen can do what you do, Superman.
Yeah, but they take a lot of the work off. You know what I mean, like. Like, Superman takes care of the big shit.
I'm playing devil's advocate here, man.
All right.
I don't really feel that way about Superman. I tried to oil his muscles once, and he baked my skull for a little bit.
Ouch.
It was uncomfortable.
I wasn't sure at first if that was a bad thing or maybe a sex thing. But
All right. Well, yeah, that's our final reviewing of Batman vs. Superman. And Mark will cut most of that out.
Yes. And I guess with that said...
I want you to keep the thumbs up and thumbs down thing in there, though.
Oh, I will.
All right. Somebody might get that.
I will.
Yeah. But good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
Yes, until
Matt Archer Media. Until next time.
Yes, this has been Brett the Shitman Fart, and I guess the Western Jesus himself here on Western.
Yes, Western Jesus.
I guess.
Ramble. Hallelujah.
Amen, sister.
And there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Probably more gentlemen than ladies, but that was the extended Batman vs. Superman review featuring Brett Sherrard, a.k.a. Brett the Shitman Fart. I am never going to stop saying that, so if Brett, if you were lying to me and truly don't like that name, you need to tell me because I'm going with it. I love it. It's fun to say. It's fun to hear. And I think it's going to look great on a fucking shirt or poster or maybe even a tattoo someday, sir. Not on me, but you know. But anyway, there you have it. That's episode 1 of Western Jesus. And until next time.
Fuck all of you.